ओम नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो ऋषिभ्यो महद्यो नमो गुरुभ्य सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान घन प्रत्यगर्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि नारायणं पद्मभुवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महांतं गोविंद योगीन्द्रमथासि शिष्यं श्रीशंकराचार्यमथासि पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तन्तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यान् अस्मद्गुरून् सन्ततमस्मि। श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूच्चतस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णमहं नमामि। यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्गमनन्तसुखाकृतिम्। So left side I'll have the vyakhya, tatha shrotavyeti, and right side we'll have the tika. So yesterday we saw in the earlier page of the tika. So there it was said, siddham brahmatmekyam vishayam vidhivat tattvamasi ityadi shrutyoho ekavakyatvaya dardhyaya cha paramparaya vidhita api sadhayati. So through the Arthavada Vakya as well as Vidhi Vakya, what can be known? The Anubandha Chatushtaya, that can be known. So Adhikari in the, as the first factor, so Adhikari, we know that Pratishtha Kamaha Adhikari in the Ratri Satra Yaga. So one who wants Pratishtha is an Adhikari. Other factors will be there definitely. But then, other factors being there, this is actually addressing Vaidikas alone, not Avaidikas. So Vaidikas are anyway assumed. Those who have done the chanting of the Vedas, they have learned the chanting of the Vedas, they know how to, which section to look into for what kind of Yaga, etc. So there, Ratri Satra Yaga tells you that Pratishtha Kamaha. One who is Pratishtha Kama is an Adhikari, because the Phala is Pratishtha as an Arthavada Vakya. In the Vidhi Vakya it is not found, but then still you can find out who is the Adhikari. Similarly here in the Vidhi Vakya Adhikari is not mentioned. So Aham Brahmasmi Ityadina Vidhi Sannita Vakyena. These are Arthavada Vakyas. Aham Brahmasmi as per the Karma Kandis. Now Siddham Brahmakya Brahma Atma Aikyam. This is a Vishaya. So after Adhikari, Vishaya can also be known, which is the second in the set of four in the Anubandha Chatushtaya. That can be known through what? The Tattvamasi Arthavada Vakya as well as Paramparaya Vidhita Api, through the Vidhi Vakya also. So Tatha Shrotavya Vyakya, Tatha Shrotavya Ityatra Pratyarthasya Niyogasya Prakrityartho Vicharo Vishaya. So what is the Vishaya there? When you hear Shrotavya, what is the meaning of Shrotavya? Vedangas have been studied, therefore Vyakrana knowledge is there. So Shru is the Dhatu, Tavya Pratyaya, it is a Krudanta Shabda. So in the Krudanta Shabda, Tavya Pratyaya has been added. So some Kartavyatvam is known. And Shru Dhatu tells you Shravana should be done. There you have Kartavyatvam. Ityatra Pratyartha. What is the Pratyartha? Pratyartha Niyogasya. it tells you it whoever listens is connected to some kriya as to be done. This has to be done. And what is the prakriti artha tavya? Prakriti artha is vicharaha. That is the vishaya. The prakriti artha. Prakriti is what? Prakriti and pratyaya. To pratyaya, whatever precedes the pratyaya, that part is called as, to whichever the pratyaya was added, that is called as prakriti. So that prakriti artha is what? Vichara. Shrudhatu artha is vichara. Why? Because shravana, you listen, cognize this. So there, when you listen, it is not just plain hearing. It is listening, meaning what I have listened to, I should understand that, I should cognize that. And when the cognition takes place, shabda jnana takes place, shabda bodha takes place, then there is inquiry embedded in this because I have understood it. If I have not understood it, then I have to do vichara. So if tattvamasi has been heard, shrotavya has been heard, then what should I listen to? Or what is the meaning of tattvamasi? There I have to do vichara. Therefore, vicharaha is vishaya. In the shrotavya mantra also, vichara is the vishaya. Tika, tatha adhikari vad ityartha. There, tatha shrotavya ityatra. When one hears shrotavya, just like ratri satra vidhi. When one hears, the shrotavya is also vidhi, because tavya pratyaya is there. Thereby, I know that it is a vidhi, and I also know the adhikari here. How? Through arthavada vakya. There is vidhi sannyata shrotavya, shabda has, mantra has another vakya elsewhere in the vicinity, tattvamasi, etc. These kind of vakyas, which are arthavada vakyas, there the arthavada vakya will have some kind of phala. Tattvamasi, that Brahma you are, Anandatmaka Brahma you are, Amruta Brahma you are. Therefore, Amrutatva Kama is the Adhikari. This can be known through the Arthavada Vakya as well as this Shrotavya Vakya Paramparaya. Because Shrotavya Vakya is a Vidhi Vakya which has some phala. In Mimamsa, you know that there is some phala, although it is not mentioned along with Shrotavya, it is mentioned elsewhere in the near vicinity. Thereby, Paramparaya. Vidhita api sadayati tatha shrotavyati. And what is that? Tatha adhikari vad ityartha. There is an adhikari for this also. Niyoga, what is niyogaha? Niyogasya, pratyartasya niyogasya. Pratyartha is niyoga. What is that? Niyoga apurvam iti prabhakara matam. So there is a prabhakara bhatta whose mata is, so bhatta mata is kumarla bhatta mata. Whereas Prabhakara Mata is separated out. He was Kumarila Bhatta Shishya. There are differences in the Pramanas also, which they consider as how many Pramanas and what exactly is Pramana and this Adhyasa also, what is the. So we'll see that a little later. Anyway, it will come. But Niyoga is Apurvam. Apurvam means you do not know this from any other source other than this Shrotavya Mantra, other than the Shruti. So Shabda Eka Eva Pramanam. Asmin Vishaye. Therefore, Niyoga, that you should do this Shravana, for that, this is Apurva Vidhi as per Prabhakaramata, Tanmatam Avalambya Vidher Artha Kathayati. So, taking his meaning the Prabhakaramata into consideration, Vidhe Artha, Vidhe Artham Kathayati. What is the Artha of this Vidhi Shrotavya now? So, there Shrotavya Iti. So, that is Tata Shrotavya Iti. Ityatra pratyartasya. So we know as to Vedanta Vishaya iti shakyam nyatum. So that is vicharasya. Vichara kartavya, that much can be known by apurva vidhi. Then further pratyaha tavya pratyaha. What is pratyaha? Tavya pratyaha, krit pratyaha. Shru is shru shravane iti dhatu, shru dhatu. Prakriti riti vivekaha. So shrudhatu is prakriti and pratyaya is tavya pratyaya, that we already seen. Vicharasya niyoga vishayatvam nama niyoga hetuka kriti vishayatvam. What is the meaning of this vicharasya niyoga vishayatvam? Because niyogasya prakriti artha vichara vishaya. Vichara is vishaya for this which you know from the pratyaya. From pratyaya you know that something has to be done. And what is that? That Vishaya is hidden in the Prakriti. That Prakriti happens to be the Shru Dhatu. So, Shravanam Kartavyaha Maya. This is the Shabda Voda there. So, what does that mean? Vishaya is Vichara. So, there it is said as Vicharasya Niyoga Vishayatvam means Nama Niyoga Hetuka Kriti Vishayatvam. Kriti is Yatna, Prayatna. So, I have to take some effort, make some effort. For what? This for vichara. So vicharasya niyoga vishayatva means niyoga hetuhu hetuka. So bahuri is indicated there. Niyoga hetuhu yasya kritehe. So niyoga, this niyoga apurva vidhi is the hetu for which prayatna in the person, in the listener, that is niyoga hetuka kritihi. And what is the vishaya for that? What should I do? किम कर्तव्यम मया कुत्र प्रयत्न कस्मिन विषये प्रयत्न कर्तव्यः विचार विषये सो दी विचार इज दी विषय फॉर दैट सो आई शुड डू विचार एंड विचार ऑफ व्हाट सो देयर विचार इज नोन आई हैव टू डू विचार दिस मच इज नोन व्हेन वन हियर्स दिस श्रवण विधि श्रोतव्यः भवतु विचारो विषयः सो पूर्वपक्ष टू दी पूर्वपक्ष विच इज सिद्धांती is assume siddhanti vishayaha vicharaha vicharo vishayaha bhavatu let the vichara be the vishaya for this shravana vidhi okay. Somebody is joining now just give me a moment so bhavatu vicharaha vishayaha tathapi prakrute kim ayatam ityatah vicharasya iti So, Purvapakshi is saying that you can know this through the Shravana Vidhi also, Anubandha Chatushtaya. Now, the question to that is, okay, let it be, Vishaya you can know, but how does it connect here? So, the Purvapakshi explains, Vicharasya Vedanta Vishaya Iti Shakyam Jnatum. Once you know Vichara Kartavya, what should you do Vichara of? This Vidhi itself has come in the Jnana Kanda, in Vedanta, Upanishad. So what should you do vichara on? Vedanta Vakya, what else? Therefore, Vedanta Ardi Vishaya is obvious there iti shakyam jnatum. At least possibility is there, do you agree? Or anyone who has some understanding knows that in Jnanakanda I have heard Shrotavya, therefore Jnanakanda itself is Vishaya for this vichara. Tika, therefore Vishaya Uddeshya ityartha. This Vishaya, Vedanta Vishaya is what is Uddeshya. Keeping this into account, the Vidhi has been given by the Shruti. Therefore, Uktarthe Hetum Aha. What is the Hetu for this? Why does he say so? In the Vyakhya, it is said, Atma Drashtavya Iti Advaita Atma Darshanam Uddeshya. Shrotavya Iti Vichara Vidhanat. So vichara, when shrotavya has been mentioned, the vishaya is vichara. And this vichara, vichara of what? So for vichara, vichara has been asked to be done keeping this Vedanta Vakya in mind. These Arthavada Vakyas. Therefore, Atma Drashtavya. Shrotavya follows this mantra. Atma va are drashtavya. आत्मदर्शनम कर्तव्यः देयरफॉर आत्मदर्शनम उद्दिश्य श्रोतव्यः विधिः दीयते सो श्रोतव्य विधि इज गिवन विद दिस इन माइंड दैट विचारा विचार विषय विचार इज विषय फॉर श्रोतव्य विधि बट दी विचारस्य विषयः कः देयर दिस अर्थवाद वाक्य विल फॉल इनटू प्लेस Thereby, Atma Drashtavya Iti Advaita Atma Darshanam Uddishya Shrotavya Iti Vichara Vidhanat. Tika. Uktam Hetum Vivrunoti. Then he explains this Hetu. What is in my mind? He elaborates that Nahi Iti. So there are two ways. So Nahi Iti Athava. So why Nahi has been mentioned? There are two ways it is explained. First way is Nahi Vicharaha. Sakshat Darshana Hetu Apramanatvat means what? That is explained in the earlier part, Uktam Hetum Vivranoti. So, same Hetu which has been mentioned, is elaborated by saying नहीं नहीं विचारा साक्षात दर्शन हेतु अप्रमाणत्वात् विचारा इज नॉट अ प्रमाण. सो पीपल से आई डू यू नो आई सिट एनीवेयर आई डोंट नीड अ गुरु व्हाई आई डोंट नीड अ श्रुति व्हाई बिकॉज फाइनली आई हैव टू लुक विद इन. सो आई लुक विद इन एंड आई डू विचारा आत्म विचारा आत्म दर्शन हैज बीन मेंशन एंड आत्म विचारा. सो आई डोंट नीड श्रुति टू टेल मी एनीथिंग आई डोंट नीड एनी गुरु I will do Atma Vichara. How will you do Atma Vichara? Even Charvakas have done Atma Vichara. They have concluded that Sharira is Atma. Some other Charvakas have concluded that the Indriya is Atma, Mana is Atma. Whether Karta Rupa Atma or Bhokta Rupa Atma. Sankhyas have concluded that Bhokta Rupa Atma but not Karta Rupa Atma. Buddhists have done Atma Vichara, have concluded there is nothing called as Atma, Shunya or Kshanika. Nayayikas base everything on a logic. So what is it that you will do something which is different and conclude the way the Shruti wants you to conclude and get moksha? It is not possible. Atma Vichara cannot be done independently. It is Shruti Moolaka Vichara. It is not Shushka Tarka. So Vichara, Nahi Vichara Sakshat Darshan Hetu. When it has been mentioned that Shrotavya, there Shrudhatu tells you Vedanta Vakya Vichara Kartavya. We have seen earlier. Vichara Eva Kartavya, Vedanta Vakya Eva Kartavya. So this Atma Vichara, if you say, Vichara itself is not a Pramana. Nobody lists in none of the darshanas, vichara is listed as a pramana. So vichara sakshat darshana hetu na bhavati. Kimartham tasya apramanatvat. It is not a pramana at all. So this is the elaboration. Further, athava in the tika, other way to interpret this is what? Athava nanu vicharasya darshana hetu tve api. Even if you accept that, okay, vichara, hypothetically. So, Abhyupagamvada as to hypothetically, if I say that Vichara is Darshana Hetu, let's assume. It is not so, but let's assume. Even if it is so, Katham Vedantanam Vichara Vishyattvam Ityashankya Kim Tad Hetuttvam Sakshat Paramparayava Na Adhya Iti Aha Nahi Iti. So, now there are two options. If at all Vichara is also Darshana Hetu, it will lead you to Atma Darshana, then this Vichara Vishyattva of Vedanta, you are establishing that Vedanta Vichara Kartavya can be known. This is Purvapakshi answering, okay? Purvapakshi is saying that Anubandha Chatushta is possible without the Sutra. Why do you create this Sutra? And if you don't need the Sutra, then you don't need this Adhyasa Vashya, etc. Now to that, if you say no, now he assumes that Siddhanti is objecting, no, this Sutra is needed. Why? Anubandha Chatushta cannot be established. And how it cannot be established? So this Siddhanti, he assumes, is proving, countering his argument that Vedanta, even if you say that Vichara is Darshana Hetu, still Vedanta Vichara has to be done, cannot be known. Vichara Vishayatvam Vedantanam Iti Ashankyan Katham. How is it that you conclude that Vichara Kartavya and Vichara is Pramana for Atma Darshana, but how is it that Vedanta Vichara Kartavya, that is not established? If the Purvapakshi is to be countered by the Siddhanti in such a manner, then Kim Tad Hetutvam, is it because, do you know that Vedantas are Vichara Hetu, due to what reason? To Sakshat or Paramparaya. Is it directly known or sequentially through some Krama you know that the Vedanta is on which Vichara should be done. Then he says, Nahi Vichara Sakshat Darshanetu Apramanatvat. With this, these options, he says, not so. So Vedanta alone will lead you to moksha. Therefore, Vichara should be done on Vedanta. Then only Atma Darshana is possible. Therefore, you can know that Vedanta is the subject matter of Vichara. This is the answer of Purvapakshi. Thereby, na adhyaha, meaning Saksha directly You cannot know that Vedanta is the Vishaya. But how can you know? Because Vichara is not Sakshat Darshana Hetu, because it is not a Pramana. Therefore, you need something else to do Vichara on. That Vichara, how it has to be done, on what it has to be done, all that will be explained only by the Vedanta Upanishad part. Therefore, it is not Sakshat. Directly you don't know, but if you inquire, you know. Then pramanam eva sakshat darshana hetu pramanam tu vedanta eva ataha pramana bhinnatvat tarka roopa vicharo na sakshat darshana hetu iti bhavaha. What is the idea here in the first option of vichara is not sakshat darshana hetu, atma darshana hetu, because pramana alone can give you jnana. Say, what is atma darshana? Atma darshana is not directly seeing the atma, it is not objectifying it, but it is jnana. Pratyaksha pramana, if Chakshurindriya gives you ghata jnana. When you look at a ghata, ghata jnana is due to pratyaksha pramana. Pramana should be there, that happens to be Chakshurindriya. So finally you have ghata jnana through the pratyaksha pramana, that is called as ghata darshana. Now this atma jnana will be called as atma darshana, which is mentioned as drashtavya. Atma drashtavya means atma darshanam kartavya. Kena margena kartavya? Shrotavya. So therefore shravana, shravanam kartavyam. Shravanena atma darshanam kartavya, and shravana meaning vichara. Vicharena, atma vicharena. Now vicharena, kasya vicharena has not been mentioned. So that has to be Vedanta alone, that is established by saying pramana should be there. And pramana meva sakshat darshanetu me, sakshat jnana hetu, atma jnana hetu, brahma jnana hetu. Therefore what is that pramana? Brahma vishaye, brahma, brahmatmani. Vishaye Vedanta eva pramanam, that is established. Therefore pramana is known as Vedanta alone, Upanishad alone. Therefore ataha pramana bhinnatva tarka rupa vichara. This vichara is tarka rupa, and that tarka by itself cannot be pramana. It has a dependency on Upanishad. It is not shushka tarka. Therefore vicharaha tarka rupa vicharaha na pramanam, and therefore na sakshat darshana hetu iti bhavaha. Dvitiye, the second option is what? Paramparaya. You know, you don't know directly as to, you don't know this directly as to Vishaya for Vichara is Vedanta. Then Paramparaya you know. Through Parampara, Dvitiye, Param, in the Parampara option, Paramparaya iti Dvitiye Vedantanam Tadvishetvam Durvaram ityaha. So if you say that Parampara it is, then anyway you know that Vedanta is the Vishaya. You cannot avoid that, because there is a dependency. What is the dependency? On Upanishad, Vedanta. Therefore that cannot be, that dependency cannot be avoided in the Parampara, if you take the Parampara option. Therefore Tarka is not independent. Therefore it is said Apitu Vyakhya Apitu Pramana Vishayatvena. So Nahi Vichara Sakshat Darshane Hetu Apramanatvat, but apitu pramana vishayatvena. Pramana vishayatva means what? Pramanaha vishayaha yasya vicharasya. Sa vichara pramana vishayaka or vishayaha vicharaha. Tasya bhava pramana vishayatvam vicharatvam. Tena pramana vishayatvena. Tena pramana vishayatvena kim? Sakshat darshana hetutvam. So sakshat darshana hetu, it isn't, sorry, it is darshana hetutvam, not sakshat, darshana hetutvam. So darshana hetutvam pramana vishayatvena vicharasya. So vichara is not directly pramana, it is not pramana, therefore it is not directly darshana hetu, atma darshana hetu, but pramana vishayatvam. Pramana is Vedanta, so Vedanta vishayatvena. Vedanta is the vishaya for this vichara. And only with that subject matter in this vichara ongoing, it can be led to the karta of the vichara, can be led to the atma and have atma jnana. Tika. Pramanam vishayaha uddeshyam yasya vicharasya satatha. So this is the Bahuri explained. Vishaya is uddeshya. And thereby this pramana is what? Vedanta. Pramana, pramanam vedantaha vishayaha उद्देश्य उद्देश्यम उद्देश्यम यस्य विचारस्य सतथा सतथा मीन्स स प्रमाण विषय दैट इज दी समास आई एक्सप्लेन देयर वेदांत वाक्यानु वाक्यानि उद्देश्य विचार क्रियते अतः वेदांतानाम उद्देश्यत्व रूप विषयत्वं संभवति निश्चित वेदांतानामेव शाब्दबुद्धौ हेतुत्वात् निश्चय विशिष्ट वेदांत प्रमाण द्वारा विचारस्य हेतुत्वञ्च संभवति इति भावः सो द पूर्वपक्षी एंड्स हिज आर्ग्युमेंट एज टू हाउ विषय कैन बी नोन फ्रॉम द श्रुति एंड यू डू नॉट नीड द सूत्र फॉर दैट सो व्हाट इज ये वेदांत वाक्यानि उद्दिश्य विचारः क्रियते विचार इज डन कीपिंग इन माइंड वेदांत वाक्य नॉट एनीथिंग एल्स नॉट यू आर नॉट थिंकिंग ऑफ घटपटादि और यू आर नॉट थिंकिंग ऑफ स्वर्ग यू आर नॉट थिंकिंग ऑफ अग्निहोत्र हाउ इट कनेक्ट्स ऑल दैट यू आर थिंकिंग अबाउट हाउ डज तत्त्वमसि मेक सेंस हाउ डज अहम ब्रह्मास्मि मेक सेंस देयरफॉर विचार इज बेस्ड ऑन दैट उपनिषद वाक्य अतः वेदांतानाम उद्देश्यत्व रूप विषयत्वम सो विषय इज उद्देश्य रूप दैट इज द वाक्य कंसीडरिंग विच दिस विचार हैज टू बी डन ऑन दैट इज सब्जेक्ट मैटर देयरफॉर विषयत्वम संभवति विचारस्य वेदांत वेदांत इज द विषय फॉर दिस विचार दैट कैन बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड निश्चित वेदांतानामेव एंड दिस विचारित which has been inquired into, where the doubts are no longer there. That is the result of vichara, because vichara will give you abhadita jnana, that jnana which cannot be countered by anything. It is siddha for you. So it is nishchita. Nishchita vedanta naam eva shabda buddhau hetutvat. So first of all, you have to know, in shravana you have to know what is the Upanishad trying to say. In Manana, you will convince yourself as to it is talking about me. You know what the Tatparya Vishaya is in the Upanishad by Shravana, and in Manana, you know that you are the Tatparya Vishaya, that Brahma. And that Manana has an overlap in Shravana itself, because Vichara is the meaning of Shravana. Therefore, Nishchita Vedantanam Eva Shabda Buddhau. When Shabda Buddhi takes place, Shabda Bodha takes place, what is the Vakya Jnana Tattvamasi? Then that will become the Hetu. Hetu Tvat Nishchaya Vishishta Vedanta Pramana Dvara. Then it is not some statement which is not making sense. It is that which makes complete sense, and that other than which there is no other sense. Meaning, this is the Tatpari of the Shruti. Without this, moksha is impossible, and I am Brahma. That is the pramana conclusion there. Hetu tvat nischaya vishishta vedanta pramana dvara vicharasya hetu tvancha sambhavati iti bhavaha. Therefore, vichara is the hetu for what? Atma darshana. This is how you know as to vedanta is the vishaya. So, adhikari and vishaya both can be known from the shruti itself. फर्दर ननु प्रमाणस्य विचारे जन्यत्वाभावात् ननु प्रमाणस्य विचारे जन्यत्वाभावात् कथं विचारस्य प्रमाण द्वारा हेतुत्वम् इति चेत् न सो प्रमाणस्य विचारे जन्यत्व अभावात् कथं विचारस्य प्रमाण द्वारा हेतुत्वम् इति चेत् हाउ इज विचारा गोइंग टू लीड टू आत्मदर्शन थ्रू प्रमाण through Vedanta, because Pramana is not Vichara Janya. So Pramanasya Vichara Janyatva Bhavat. How do you know that Vedanta is the Vishaya? If that doubt is still raised, if you still question it, then Pramanadara Hetutvam Katham Vicharasya. How is it an Atma Darshana Hetu Vichara? How will you know? न सर्वं वेदांत वाक्यं ब्रह्म तात्पर्यकम् इति तात्पर्य निश्चयस्य विचारजन्यत्वेन विशिष्ट प्रमाणस्य विचारजन्यत्व उपचाराद् इति भाव इट इज एन औपचारिक प्रयोग हियर डायरेक्टली विल नॉट नो सो व्हाट इज ही सेइंग इज दैट प्रमाणस्य विचारजन्यत्वं प्रमाण लीड्स टू विचार दिस pramana is the vishaya on which you do vichara, and then this pramana dwara you get atma darshana. So hetutvam kasya hetutvam, hetutvam for atma darshana finally. So sarva vedanta vakyam, when you analyze the statements which are there in the Upanishad, whether it is one or across Upanishads, then what will happen? You will have tatparya nishchaya. This is with the shadlinga, shadlinga vichara. So shadlinga, if you apply shadlingas, then through six indicators as to upakrama, upakrama, upasamhara. This is one linga. Upakrama, upasamhara. Then arthavada upapatti. Upakrama, upasamharo, abhyaso, apurvata, phalam. So abhyasa, what is repeated. Upakrama upasamhara is what the Upanishad begins with and what it ends with. That is one linga, one indicator. Thereby you can know tatparya vishaya. Then abhyasa, what is repeated, what is important, what is tatparya vishaya will be repeated across the Upanishad. Tattvamasi has been repeated 9 times. Upakrama upasamhara, upakrama is yasya jnanena ekena jnanena sarvam vijnatam bhavati kim tat. What is that? Knowing which you know, you as well know everything. And then it has been concluded as to, you know, the karana jnanena karya jnanam, sarva karya jnanam in Chandogya Upanishad. Thereby upakrama upasamhara tell you the tatpare vishaya is brahma, which is jagat karana brahma. And then tattvamasi repeated 9 times. Naukrata upadesha, that is what? That is you. That jagat karana brahma is you. So abhyasa, then apurvata phalam, nowhere else it is known only in the Upanishad. So apurvata is there, and the other three lingas, arthavada upapatti cha, arthavada and upapatti also is there. Upakrama upasamaharo abhyasa purvata phalam. Phala is also there. So brahmaveda brahmayo bhavati in some Upanishad, or ananda prapti. So that is mentioned there, phala also. So brahmaveda brahmayo bhavati means brahma jnana will make you brahma. You cannot become brahma if you are non-brahma. So it will tell you that you are already brahma. So ananda prapti, all this is phala is mentioned. Brahma itself is the phala. Brahma jnana leads to brahmatvam, brahma bhava. Meaning it takes away abrahma bhava, that is the idea there. So dukkha nivritti, ananda prapti, because swarupa is, brahma swarupa is atma swarupa now, which is ananda rupa. So phala is the fourth, thereby you know what is the tatpare vishaya of Vedanta. Then the abhyasa apurvata phalam arthavada upapatti cha. Arthavada we already seen, some glorification will be there, tarati shokam atmavit, etc. So one will cross over all grief. This is the arthavada. In the antakarana there can be grief, but ananda swarupa atma has no objection to that kind of grief because it is asanga. Tatpare vishaya is ananda rupa brahma. Therefore, knowing that, if you hold on to that, tarati shokam atmavit, then you have these statements which are artha upapatti. Some tarka is used in the shastra itself as to how is it so. So some color coding is mentioned to find out everything in the karya is karana in chandogya. So whatever you see rakta rupa in the prapancha, that is all karana in the form of Tejas. And Tejas is a Devata which has come from Brahma, therefore it is Brahma. So such kind of logic is given to trace back Karya to Karana. Thereby six indicators are there through which you can know the Tatparya. So Sarvam Vedanta Vakyam, each and every Vedanta Vakya is Brahma Tatparyakam. Brahma Tatparya yasya sarvasya vedanta vakyasya tat sarvam vedanta vakyam brahma tatparyakam. All the statements of Upanishad are focused towards the singular goal of aikya, advaita, brahma. Advaita Brahma. So, Ekameva Dvitiya Brahma is the tatpariya of all Vedanta Vakya. Sarvam means all anyway, and each and everyone also. And Vedanta Vakya, if you say, you know, Jato Ekavachanam. Thereby, Tatpare Nishchayasya Vichara Janyatvena. How do you establish this, that Tatpariya is Brahma of all Upanishad? By Vichara. Vichara is based on what now? When you are doing Tatpare Nishchaya, in the initial stage, what is this Shravana leading me to Shravanam Kartavyam Maya of Upanishad Vakyas? And this Upanishad Vakyas have the Tatpare in a singular goal. How do you know? By Shadlinga. That Shadlinga is also Vicharatmaka. Then finally you land on Tattvamasi being told 9 times. That is the Vishaya. Advitiya Brahma is the Vishaya through all 6 indicators. And then that Pramana will start working. Therefore, Vichara Janyatvam Asti Eva. Pramanasya. Pramanasya Vichara Janyatvam Katham, if you ask. Yes, it is there. You inquire into the all the Upanishads, you will find the same goal. Therefore, Vichara is definitely there in... Vichara is definitely going to lead to Mukti via this Pramana itself. Therefore, Pramanasya Vichara Janyatvam Asti Eva. Thereby, Vishishta Pramanasya Vichara Janyatva Upacharad. So, you have to at least accept that Upachara is there, because Sakshat Darshanetu it isn't, Paramparaya it is. Since it will lead you to this Pramana which will start working. Iti Bhavaha Atindriyarthe Shrutireva Svatanta Pramana Mityaha. And if nothing, then how do you know if you ask? You ask any Vaidika. Is Swarga there? Yes, it is there. You ask a Laukika who has nothing to do with the Swarga Ityadi. Is Swarga there? He says, I don't care. I want to take a vacation to Switzerland. I want to, you know, shift out and have a summer house, winter house, what not, all around the world. But I am not interested in Swarga. I don't care. So that vacation is Sukarupa. That is Swarga as per Purvamimamsaka will say, wherever you have, you know, Sukadrushti, that will indicate that you have Swarga Icha also. Because Swarga is Sukarupa. So you are actually searching for Swarga. This is, even if you do not accept it, this is the Purvamimamsaka Vaidika will tell you so. Which means he has Dhrida Shraddha in Swarga being there. What is this Swarga? As revealed in the Shruti Apurva, it is not known from any other Pramana. So, Atindriyarthe, Swargadi Vishaye, Aikya Vishaye Api, Shruti Reva Swatantra Pramanam. Every other thing will have a dependency on Shruti, like this Vichara. Vichara is not a Pramana. Tarka is not a Pramana, but you say Tarka is Anumana, and Anumana is a Pramana, then Vichara indirectly can be a Pramana, but it is not an independent Pramana. It has dependency on some Upajivya. That Upajivya has to be Pratyaksha in the case of Anumana, and in the case of Vichara here, it has to be Shruti. In the context, Prakrute Shruti Reva. Shruti Upajivya, on which the Tarkatmaka Vichara has dependency. It is Upajivi. It lives upon that. Otherwise, Tarka cannot survive. Vichara cannot survive unless there is a Vishaya. That Vishaya is the Vedanta which is Mula Pramana, Upajivya Pramana. And that happens to be Shruti. Why? Because this Vishaya is Atindriya Vishaya. Atindriyarthe Shruti Reva Svatantra Pramana Mitya Pramanancha. Vyakhya Pramanancha Advaitatmani Vedanta Eva Tanto Upanishadam Purusham Prichami Vedanta Vidyana Sunishchitarthaha Iti Shrute He. And what is the Pramana on which this Tarka has to survive? This Vichara will go on. That has to be based on the Tatparya. Tatparya is Advaitatma, which cannot be known by any other means. You cannot know. Even if you say, oh, I'll do yoga, I'll do this Sankhya, I'll do self inquiry. I'll use my teacher's teaching who has absolutely no connection with Vedas. Okay. Let's say you get samadhi. You know that you are different from the stula sharira, you are different from the sukshma sharira. Stula sharira, sukshma sharira, description itself cannot come without Veda Vedanga. Even if you have studied Ayurveda, there Ayurveda is a Vedanga. So it won't work. These arguments won't work as to I will somehow land on it without Shruti. Even if you land hypothetically, you will land on that Atma which is Pratyagatma. How will you know that there are no other Pratyagatmas other than you? So you are meditating and you say that I have got Samadhi, I have Jnana of Pratyagatma. Okay, be it so. Although Samadhi is not a Pramana. Let's say, assume that you have landed on the understanding that I am Sharira Bhinna, Prana Bhinna, all the Kosha Bhinna, Pancha Kosha Bhinna, Atma Aham Asmi. Satchit Ananda Swarupa, because in Samadhi you have Ananda, you know you are Chaitanya and you exist. So Satta and Chitta is not an issue. Ananda, which was an issue, has been resolved and you know that in Samadhi that you are Ananda Swarupa Atma. Satchit Ananda Atma Aham Asmi. Okay, your spouse is meditating next to you, your children are meditating next to you, or you are in a group meditation, they are also there. Let's say your acharya is so great and all of you are trained so much that everyone is in samadhi. Everyone is in samadhi, they know that they are Satchidanandatma. Even with that assumption, how do you know that Pratyagatma of Devadatta is different from Yajnadatta? For that, Shruti eva pramanam. Therefore, Advaita Atma. Atmani. In Atma you may say, okay, I know by any other means. Possible, let's say hypothetically, still not accepted, but hypothetically if you accept, then also Advaita Atmani Kim Pramanam. Absolutely no other possibility is there other than Vedanta. Vedanta Eva. Vedantaha Eva. Impossible that any other source will give you Advaita Jnana. Why so? Because in Upanishad it is discussion is what? Purusha, this Purusha, that Purusha, not Sankhya Purusha where Prakriti, Pradhana and Purusha are separated. Completely independent. Purusha, Purusha is separated. Then they have some Vishishta Purusha. Supreme, they call it a supreme person, Ishvara. In Seshwara Sankhya. In Sankhya also there is Nirishvara and Seshwara. Division. Generally, Nirishvara is accepted. Yoga brings in Ishvara, which is the practice of Sankhya, which is theory. Even with that assumption, if you say Ishvara is there, that Ishvara is separate anyway. From Pradhana also, meaning Prakriti or Maya in our case. And the Jiva is Bhinna from other Jiva. Jiva is Bhinna from Ishvara. Jiva is Bhinna from everything. From this Prapancha. So Jiva is all segmented. It is prapta in samadhi also, in yoga samadhi. But that is not that Purusha. Who is Purusha in Sankhya? In yoga also it is that Purusha, which is free from the Panchakosha. Okay, you know that. But in Upanishad, that is not the Purusha discussed. Which Purusha is discussed? Tanto Upanishadam Purusham Prichami. I don't ask you about this Purusha who is known with other Pramanas. The questioner is asking in Upanishad as to what is that discussed in the Upanishad, you tell me. Which is the Pramana? Therefore, what is the Pramana in Advaita Atma? I want to know Advaita Purusha. That is the intention there. Tantu Upanishadam Purusham. Upanishad Ekagamyam. That is the meaning. Upanishad Ekagamyam. One that can be known only through Upanishad. That is the Purusha I want to know. That is the kind of disciple in the dialectic of the Shruti. Not some Tom, Dick and Harry who wants to know any Purusha and then he says, okay, I got Samadhi or I got some Siddhi, I'm happy. No, he wants Nitya Moksha. Therefore, Upanishadam Purusham Prichami, Vedanta Vidyana Sunishchitartha. Who are the sannyasis who have got, who are Vidvat sannyasis, Paramahamsa sannyasis? So Mundaka Upanishad says that Vedanta Vijnana Sunishchitarthaha. Those who have known Nishchayena, Sushtu Nishchayena, they have known what? Vedanta Vijnana, what is discussed in Vedanta, in Upanishad. Therefore, Vedanta alone is the Pramana iti Shrutehe. Tika, Eva Karena Anumanadehe Pramanyam Nirasyate. When it is said Eva, Vedanta Eva, Advaitatmani Pramanancha Vedanta Eva, then Eva Kara is, in what sense is mentioned here, Eva Karena. Eva Karena Anumanadehe Pramanyam Nirasyate. Anumana is not a Pramana. Tarkikas cannot land on Atma because it is Shushka Tarka. It is independent. Independently, it is not a Pramana in this Atindriyartha Vishaya, Atma, Advaita Atma. Shrotartha Sambhavana Arthatvena Gunataya Pramanyangikari Api Na Mukhya Pramanyam Iti Bhava. So there can be an objection from a Tarkika. How do you say Tarka is not a Pramana, Anumana? Anumana is definitely a Pramana. You, Vedantis, yourselves count Anumana as what? Next Pramana to Pratyaksha, Pratyaksham, Anumanam, and so on. Anumiti, Karanam, Anumanam. Anumiti is a Prama, so Anumana is a Pramanam. How do you say it is not a Pramana? Oh, we are talking about Shruti here, so Shrautartha Sambhavana, Arthatvena. In establishing what is the commitment of the Shruti, I may use Anumana here and there. So that, with that possibility, I accept Gunataya, not directly for Atma, but in what is the Tatpare Vishaya, I use Anumana, because that is Vakya analysis. Vakya is, although it is Vaidika, Vakya is Indriya Gamya. Therefore, it is not Atindriya, but the subject matter of the Vakya is Atindriya. Thereby, for Vakya analysis, I'll definitely use Mimamsa Shastra, I'll use Tarka, I'll use Vyakrana. But once the Vakya has been established, the meaning of the Vakya, what it is, that Vishaya is Atindriya Agamya. Sorry, it is Indriya Agamya, meaning Atindriya. Atindriya Artha. Thereby, Gunataya Pramanyangi Karyapi na Mukhya Pramanyangi. Gunataya means secondary. Secondary status is there. It has a dependency on Pratyaksha and on, in the case of Shruti, it has a dependency on Shruti. It is not a primary pramana. Upanishadam purusham. In that mantra, what is the meaning? Upanishadam, Upanishad ekagamyam ityartha. Known only through ekagamyam. Eka is only. Only through Upanishad, what you can know, that kind of purusha I inquire about. Parama prakritamaha. So what is the final meaning here? Vedantanam, Vyakhya Vedantanam cha Pratyak Brahmaikyam Vishayaha. And what is the Vishaya of Vedanta itself? Vedanta Vishaya is Pratyak Brahma Aikyam. Oneness of the innermost self, which is free from the Panchakoshas. That and Brahma, which is having Maya as Upadhi. And then you separate it from Maya, which is Nirguna Brahma. So Aikya between Ishvara and Jiva, where this Jiva is Atma, who is Upadhi Bhinna. And similarly, Ishvara is who is that Brahma, who is Maya Upadhi Bhinna. Not Virat, not Hiranyagarbha, and not with the Samashti Upadhi of Tamas also. Thereby, that kind of meaning Samashti Sushupti. He is Bhinna from that also. Thereby, Aikya is established. There is no difference. Aikya is established. There is no oneness possible there. It is one. Oneness understanding is possible by taking Upadhis on both sides by Bhagatyaga Lakshana or Jahad Ajal Lakshana. You all know that. So, Pratyak Brahma Aikyam Vishaya. Tattvam Asi Aham Brahmasmi Ityadi. So, before that, Tika. Vishaya Pratipadyaha. What is revealed in the Vedanta? Vedantanam Vishaya Kaha. So Pratyak Brahma Aikyam. That is the Vishaya. Saha Vishaya. And what is the meaning of Vishaya there? Pratipadhyaha. It is revealed by the Vedanta alone. So Vishaya is Pratipadhyaha. Nanu, which is Aikya. Aikya is revealed only in the Shruti. Nanu Vidhina Brahmatmaikyam Sputam Na Pratibhasate Tasmat Katham Vishaya Siddhi Rityashankayam Tatra Sputa Pratipadakam Pramanam Aha. So you may say, you know, this Tanto Upanishadam Purusham Vedanta Vijnana Sunichitartha all these statements you have given, but these are Vedanta statements which are not clear. How is it that you conclude that they are establishing Aikya? It is not clear. So therefore, how can you say that Aikya is the Vishaya? Vedantana cha pratyak brahma ikyam Vishaya. With what basis are you making such a statement? If that is the question, then the answer is what? Tattvamasi. Here at least you should not have doubt. Tattvamasi, that you are. It is not Atattvamasi. It is not Tasyatvamasi. It is not Tasmaitvamasi. It is not Tenatvamasi. It is not Tasmatvamasi. It is not Tasmintvamasi. It is Tattvamasi. These are two separated words. Tat and Tvam. They are not one samasa, samasta pada like others. Other darshanas, let them do whatever they want. As an Advaitin who uses no shushka tarka, he has basis on what it says. Who sees that Tattvamasi has been mentioned 9 times. If Atattvamasi were to be mentioned, we have seen yesterday as to Dvaitam na upadesha arham jata matra prani gamyatvat. So every prani which is newborn also knows that I am different from something or the other. Dvaita is already known. It need not be established by the Upanishad. If it is doing it also, then there is no pramanya buddhi at all in Vedanta, in Upanishad. That is the sthiti of others. But if we say Tattvamasi, and it will not fall with the Shadlingas also. It will not fall in place with Shadlingas. The Upanishad started by saying, knowing which you will know everything, as though. So when, meaning the search will drop off. You don't want to know anything once you know that you are Karana Brahma. Then the Karya is all your manifestation. This is the glory of the Upanishad. As to what it committed, it gave you. Unlike, you know, somebody says, I'll do this, I'll do that, and gives you nothing. These Dvaitins conclude that Atattvamasi is being given by the Upanishad. This fool who went to the Gurukula for so many years and learnt Atattvamasi learnt nothing. Because he already knew Atattvamasi. So after 12, 20, 30, 40 years lifetime study, across life study, what have you got? Atattvamasi. Okay. Pratijna of the Shruti is what? Knowing which you will know everything. Ekena vijnanena sarvam vijnatam bhavati. Is that pratijna met? So what kind of Shraddha do you have in the Shruti which has not given what she has committed, which you are okay with further? Thereby, by knowing that you are different from Ishvara, you got nothing. What did you get? Pratijna is what? You will know everything. You know next to nothing. And you remain knowing next to nothing. You are as limited as you were earlier. Even worse now, because the Shruti committed something and you wasted your entire life and she gave you nothing. This is the case of Atma Atattvamasi. To use this Dirgha Sandhi, Ekas Savarne Dirgha. Akasavarne Dirga, and then Akasavarne Dirga, you say Atma Akara, and Tattvamasi has an A there which you forcibly fit because you have concluded through other non Vedanta Pramanas, that also erroneously. So this won't work. Thereby, what has been said here, this is all Tarka proper, in keeping with what is, what should be, in keeping with the Shadlingas. If you inquire, then only Vada is possible. Dvaiti and Advaiti cannot have Vada, although there are Vidvat Sabhas, they conclude nothing. It is only for listeners' benefit. There is no agreement on anything. You look at this, here there is an agreement possible between the Purvapakshi and the Siddhanti because there is some common ground for discussion. Katham Vishaya Siddhihi Nanu Vidina Brahmatmaikyam Sputam Na Pratibhasate. The answer is Bhasate Tu Sputam Pratibhasate. Katham Tattvamasi iti ityanena vakyena. So Tattvamasi in the Vyakhya Aham Brahmasmi iti shrute he. There Aham Brahmasmi is very clear. Tattvamasi Aikya is very clear. Therefore Sputam na Pratibhasate. If you say Sputa Pratipadakam Pramanamaha Tattvamiti Vidhi Sannihitasya Swartha Tatparyaka Arthavadasya Tarati Shokamatmavid Ityadi Vakya Dvayasya Vidina Saha Eka Vakyatvaya Dardhyayacha Vidhi Phalam Nirupayan Prayojanam Nirupayati. So he is quoting Vakya Dvaya in the Vyakhya to establish this vidhi sannihita, it is near the shrotavya vidhi, and these statements are considered as arthavada. There what has been said, tarati shokam atmavit, so arthavada phala is there. Shokam tarati, atmavit shokam tarati, atmam veti, atmanam veti iti atmavit, one who knows the atma, he will cross over grief. Now this is arthavada, there is a arthavada phala also. Ityadi vakyadvayas, vakyadvaya is what? Evam, in the vyakhya, evam vichara videhe phalam api jnana dvara muktihi. This vichara vidhi will give you phala by jnana, which is pramana janya, vedanta pramana janya. When the mahavakya shabda bodha takes place, that jnana, jnana dvara muktihi. So phala is the third. You know adhikari through the shruti, you know vishaya through the shruti. Now the third is phala, prayojana. So phalam api jnana dvara mukti tarati shokam atmavit brahmavit brahmahiva bhavati ityadi shrute. There are these two statements quoted. Chandogya 7th chapter and then brahmavit brahmahiva bhavati from Brihat or Chandogya itself. So brahmavit brahmahiva bhavati becomes brahma. Actually brahmavit brahmahiva bhavati is not praised. Brahmaveda brahmahiva bhavati is praised. So this may have been there in some Upanishad earlier. So one who knows Brahma knows that he is Brahma, so he becomes Brahma as though figuratively he is already Brahma. So these vakyas, two vakyas quoted, vakya dvaya vidhi sannihitasya swartha tatparya karthas vadasya arthavadasya tarati shokam atmavid ityadi vakya dvayasya vidhina saha eka vakyatvaya. So this is connected to the vidhi. Shrotavya vidhi will give you. See, tarati shokam atmavit. So, atmanam vetti. One who knows atma will cross over grief. And how will one know that? Shrotavya vidhi is there. So, they are connected. Eka vakyata is there. So, they should be read together. Shravanena atmajnanam bhavati, atmavit bhavati, saha atmavit shokam tarati. This is the complete Shabda Bodha which should take place. Of course, Shabda Bodha is, the construct is different, but that is technical. Finally, the idea is what? Shravana is a vidhi towards me. Vedanta is a Vishaya. Vedanta, Vishaya is what? Is Upanishad. Upanishad, Eka Gamya Purusha, which is Advaita Atma. Therefore, the knowledge is regarding Ekameva Dvitiya Brahma through Tattvamasi, Aham Brahmasmi, etc. And through that, Atma with Shokam Tarati. Therefore, Phala is also connected to the Shrotavya Vakya itself because Eka Vakyata is there. And similarly with Brahmaiva Bhavati or Brahma Veda Brahmaiva Bhavati. And Dardhyacha, it is a firm conclusion now. Because Eka Vakyata is there and Dardhyacha to establish, he gives two Vakyas. Vidhiphalam nirupayan, prayojanam nirupayati. So vidhiphala is there, meaning prayojana is also there, which you know, evamiti. And then, yena tarati shokam ityadi vakyena prayojanam viditam tenaiva prapyata rupa sambandopi veditavya ityaha. Now the fourth one which is remaining in the anubandha chatushtaya is sambandha. How do you know the sambandha? Yena tarati shokam ityadi vakyena prayojanam viditam. So you know the phala as shokam tarati, and through that arthavada vakya itself you know phala also. Thereby one who wants this phala of shoka tarana is the adhikari there, adhikari is known, and then sambandha, he has the sambandha as to prapya. The shoka taranam is prapya, and who is the prapta? Is the adhikari. Who wants that shoka tarana has been already mentioned as adhikari, so phala is mentioned, then phala is prapyata rupa phala, and prapta is the karta adhikari. Therefore, prapya prapyata rupa sambandha is also there. Phala is prapya, by whom adhikari? Adhikari is the one who is praptru. So, yena tarati shokam ityadi vakyena prayojam viditam tena eva prapyata rupa sambandha api veditavya. Sambandha is also known. Therefore, it says tatha iti. I'll just finish this sentence. Tatha sambandho api adhikarina vicharasya kartavyata rupaha phalasya prapyata rupa iti. So, I am one who is adhikari because I am amrutatva kama, and therefore shravana has to be done by me, so kartavyata rupa, and Shravana will give me through Pramana. Shravana is Vichara, Vedanta Vakya Vichara, Vedanta is Pramana, that will lead to Tarati Shoka. So Shoka Tarana or Brahma, Veda Brahmaya Bhavati, I will become Brahma. Figuratively, but we'll hold on to that. I will become Brahma with, and therefore I'll become Brahma. With this figurative understanding, Kartavyata Rupa Sambandha is there between me and Shravana, and Phala is Prapya. Therefore, Prapyata Rupaya Sambandha is also there between the Vishaya which is there, that is going to lead me there. Therefore, I will get that. There is Prapyata Rupa Sambandha also. Iti Yatha Yogam Subodha. We'll see Yatha Yogam tomorrow, but here in the Tika, Kartavyata Rupa Sambandha Iti Vidina Eva Veditavya Iti Bhavaha. You know that Shravana itself tells you Shravanam Kartavya. So, Kartavyata Rupa Sambandha is there. And phala is prapya by me, therefore prapyata rupa sambandha is also revealed by the same shruti vakya, arthavada vakya also, and vidhi vakya. As necessary, you can put them together and know all four in the anumanda chatushtaya. Why do you need this sutra? So then we'll look at the response to that as to why sutra is necessary. And the Purvapakshi is counter to that by saying yatha yogam subodha in the next patha. यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्गमनन्त सुखाकृतिं तत्सत् एनि क्वेश्चन्स् वाज़ इट रीडेबल फॉर एट लीस्ट मोस्ट Because this is the only way it is smooth. Otherwise, switching windows, switching horizontally does not work well. Especially for this text where the Tika and the Vyakhya are across pages. Yeah, that is always an option available for everyone. Okay, so we'll stick to this. It is more convenient for me also. Okay, yeah. So majority say that it is readable. So hopefully, I mean, those who have trouble can switch to book or a bigger screen if you have. Okay, namaste. Yes, Padmaravanji. I tried this, I did not get this option, especially in this PDF reader, I didn't get that option. I'll see if I can use, you know, from Windows I can do something. From what? Yeah, color of the, I see I tried this earlier, but the issue with this is that, you know, the, see there is an inbuilt mechanism, but if I go to full screen, then what happens is,